see, a database file is partitioned into different storage units. We call it as a blocks. And blocks are units of both storage allocation and data transfer. So already we have seen that the main memory space is very small and not possible to store the entire database, and that's why database is stored on the disk. But where the actual execution is performed in the main memory. So for the executor simple instruction such as select R from instructor. So this instruction or this simple command, it is executed in main memory. But the block is on the disk because the data where the instructor information is stored, it is on the disk. So it is necessary to move this data, which is of instructor information, to main memory. Transferring the entire database, it is very time consuming, and that's why this this data, which is partitioned into fixed length storage unit, we call it as a block. Block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4, etc. So we call it as a block. Block 1, block 2, and so on. Now, if the information related to the instructor is stored in block number 2, then only that block number 2 is transferred from disk to main memory. It is transferred from disk to main memory, and in the main memory, the actual information or the actual instruction is executed and the result is retrieved. So, in that way, the blocks are unit of both storage allocation and data transfer. So, that part already we have seen. Again, I am repeating it. Now, these blocks, database system, what is our major goal is that to minimize the number of blocks transferred from disk to main memory. Our aim is to minimize the number of blocks transferred from disk to main memory. Why? Because transferring the block from disk to main memory, it is an I/O operation which is slower than the CPU operation. And that's why our major goal is to minimize the number of blocks transferred from disk to main memory. How we reduce this? For that, keeping as many blocks as possible in main memory. What we can do? We can keep as many blocks as possible in main memory. For that, some part of the main memory is kept aside. Okay, for that, some part of the main memory is kept aside. We call it as a buffer. So, buffer is a portion of main memory. Suppose this is our main memory. Suppose this is our entire main memory. In that, some part of the main memory or portion of the main memory, it is available to store the copies of this block. We call it as a buffer. We call it as a buffer. Everyone understood what is meant by buffer? It is very important concept. Again, we required it in this entire unit. So, portion of main memory available to store the copies of the disk block is known as buffer, and the subsystem responsible for allocating buffer space is main memory is the buffer manager. The subsystem responsible for allocating this buffer space in main memory is the buffer manager. This we call entire main memory. Everyone here, see again I am repeating it. We know that database is stored on the disk. Database is stored on the disk as it is a large size, not possible to store on in the main memory. But the actual information is executed or actual instructions are executed in main memory. So in that case, this database, we need to transfer from disk to main memory. But transferring the entire database, it is time consuming and costly, and that's why this entire database which is stored on the disk is partitioned into fixed length storage unit. We call it as a block. And instead of transferring the entire database, the block which contains that information is transferred from disk to main memory. Where it is stored in the main memory? It is stored in the buffer. So portion of the main memory available to store the copies of this block is known as buffer. And the subsystem responsible for allocation of this buffer space is known as buffer manager. Is it clear to everyone? Yes or no? It's a very important concept. Then only it is possible to understand the buffer management and the different replacement policy. Is it clear to everyone? Yes or no? I'm not receiving any response from you. May I repeat it again? The buffer management, okay? Block, buffer, and buffer manager. So always remember that blocks are stored on the disk, okay? Or we can say it is the partition of the entire database. And what is buffer? Buffer is the portion of main memory. Always remember this thing. Now see, as the block are transferred from disk to main memory, where it is stored in the buffer. So how it exactly executed? What happens? So whenever we execute any program, any instruction, machine instruction, the program call on buffer manager. So buffer manager is responsible for all these things. So program call on buffer manager when they need a block from the disk. Okay. Again, I am going to draw here that simple diagram. Again, it is a disk. It is a main memory. When we execute any instruction, that simple program, any instruction, machine instruction, that call on buffer manager, okay? When they need a block from the disk, where the block is stored normally on the disk. But as I already told that, to minimize the number of block transfers, some of blocks are already kept in the main memory in the buffer. Okay, suppose we consider this is the portion of buffer. It is buffer. If the block which is required, for example, I execute the instruction select start from instructor. So I need the information about the instructor, and the block which contains that information about the instructor, if it is already in the buffer manager returns the address of that particular block in main memory to the requester program. Transfer, it gives the returns the address of the block in the main memory to the requester if the block is already in the buffer. But if the block is not in the buffer manager, what it performs? First make a space in the buffer. The buffer manager first make a space in the buffer for that particular block. If there is space, transfer the block from disk to main memory. But if there is no space in the buffer for the new block, some block is thrown out, which are already in the buffer from main memory to disk. And that is known as buffer replacement policy. The blocks which are not required are thrown out back to the disk. And the space is created for the new block. Once the space is created for the new block, it is transferred from disk to main memory, and the address of that particular block in main memory is returned to the program, and the execution is performed. Understood? Once again, I am explaining. Suppose the programs are executed, some simple instructions are executed, then it call on buffer manager when it need a block from the disk. Now, as I told that in buffer, some disk blocks are already stored to minimize the number of block transfer. So if that block, okay, it's already in the buffer in main memory, the buffer manager returns the address of the block in the main memory to the requester. But if the block is not in the buffer, then It is necessary to make the space in the buffer for the new block. So for that, the block which is already in the buffer thrown out back to the disk. And the requested block is transferred from disk to buffer in the main memory. And once this block is transferred from disk to main memory, the address of the block is given to the requester in the main memory. Is it clear to everyone? Simple operation. How actually it executes. So here, when these blocks which are not required in the main memory, which are not required in the buffer, thrown out back to the disk. What we call it as a? We call it as a buffer replacement policy. We call it as a buffer replacement policy. Means we perform some replacement, thrown a block from this main memory to disk, and the block from disk to main memory is placed at that position. So that is known as buffer replacement policy. Now see the next task of buffer manager. So buffer replacement policy is the most of the system when there is no room left in the buffer for a block, then a block must be removed from the buffer and is transferred to the disk so that to make a place for a new block. In the most of the operating systems, which method is used? Least recently used method that already you have studied in operating system. So most of the operating system use least recently used or LRU scheme. What is LRU? The block which is least recently used. The block which is not used recently or least recently used is returned back to the disk and is removed from the buffer. Is returned back to the disk and removed from the buffer. That is the simple policy used in the operating system. Do you understand what is LRU? Already you have studied, I think, in operating system. Yes or no? Now see, along with that, there are two more conditions for the buffer replacement. What is that? One is the pinned block. So most recovery systems require that a block, see, read it, because this question normally asks for oral or for objective. Most recovery system require that a block should not be returned back to the disk while an update on the block is in progress. While the update on the block is in progress. For example, suppose I am updating some block, okay? Suppose on the disk. On the disk, there is a block where the instructor information is stored. The block where instructor information is stored. And suppose the programmer executes a query update instructor set salary is equal to salary multiply with 0.05. So what it perform it this instruction when it executes, it update the salary of all instructors. So where block is? The block which contains the instructor information is in progress. This block is first transferred from disk to main memory, and in main memory it is executed. While it is in progress, such a block is not allowed to return back to the disk. Such a block is not allowed to be returned back to the disk. That is known as pinned block. See, once again, most recovery systems require that a block should not be returned back to the disk while an update on the block is in progress. Now, instructor block, the update is in progress. So, that block is not allowed to transfer from main memory to disk. So, in that case, it is known as pinned block. Everyone clear what is meant by pin block? Now the next one, another forced output block. There are situations in which it is necessary to return back the block to the disk. Okay, from main memory to disk. Even though the buffer space that it occupies is not required. This is called as force output of a block. Means the space occupied by that block in main memory is not required. Even if the block is transferred from main memory to disk. That is known as forcefully that block is transferred from main memory to disk, that is force output of a block. Is it clear these three concepts? First, simple policy that every operating system uses least recently used means the block which is referenced least recently is written back from main memory to the disk. FinAdder blocks, the block which are in update or which are in the process of updation are not allowed to write back to the disk. So these are known as FinAdder blocks. And force output means even if the space occupied by the block is not required in main memory, that block is forcefully transferred from main memory to disk. That is called as a force output of a block. Is it clear to everyone? So that we can move to the next part. Now see another example. Again, it will be clear for you. Okay. Now see, along with this most least recently used, some other buffer replacement policies are used in the database. In most of the operating system, as I told you, that least recently used method is used. LRU scheme is used. But the database system is more powerful to predict the next block required than the operating system. Database system is more powerful than the operating system who predict the future reference. Which block is required in future, which block is not required in future. And according to that, there are different replacement policies again. One example we are going to see here. Suppose we execute the query instructor natural join requirement. What happens in this? Every instructor tuple is attached with every department tuple. Every instructor tuple is attached. Suppose this is instructor and this is department. So every instructor tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department. So first tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department where instructor.id, sorry, department name is common, where instructor.department name is equal to department.department name. So every tuple of instructor attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Once first tuple is completed, it go for the next tuple attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Then the next tuple, then the next tuple, then the next tuple. So in this way, every tuple of the instructor attached with every other tuple of the department. Suppose we execute this instructor natural join department. What actual the instruction is executed or in programming language, how we can execute, write it? For each tuple I of the instructor do. For each tuple D of the instructor do. If the equality on those attributes which are common in both the relation, which is common in both the relation, in both the relation department name is common. So I dot department name is equal to D dot department name. And here we use another temporary variable X to store the result of the natural join. So x dot id is equal to I dot id. The instructor id goes first. Then x dot department name is equal to I dot department name, instructor department name. X dot name is equal to instructor name, salary, building, and the budget. So in the resulting relation of this, how many number of tuples are there? In the resulting relation, there are 5 tuples which are id, which is common in both the relation, appears only once. Then name, then if I dot department name, as it is a common in both the relation, instructor dot department name, we use, need to use the prefix. Then salary, ID, department name, sorry, ID, department name appears only once. Then building, okay. And then budget. So these 5 attributes appear in the result when we perform the instructor natural join, and these are stored in the new variable X that is only in this program. Simple. Every tuple of instructor attached with every tuple of the department, and the result is stored in the temporary variable X. Now see, observe which replacement policies are required in this case. This suppose instructor tuple and this is the department tuple. Block 1, now we know that the file is partitioned into fixed length storage unit. We call it as a block. Now block 1 contains 4 tuples, block 2 contains these 4 tuples, and block 3 contains these 4 tuples. Means in one block we can store the 4 tuples of instructor. Similarly, block 1 and block 2. So these first four tuples in the block 1, these three four tuples are in the block 2 of the department. Now how the natural join operation executes? It attaches every tuple of the instructor with every other tuple of the department. So see how the operation is executed. This first tuple is attached with every other tuple of the instructor, where department dot department instructor dot department name is equal to department dot department name. Once the operation of this tuple is completed, it goes for the next tuple. Then this tuple is attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Then the third tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department. Then fourth tuple of the instructor attached with every other tuple of the department. After completion of the entire block or the processing of the entire block, whether these tuples are required in future, yes or no? Have you understood my question? See once again. This tuple, first tuple of the instructor, attached with every other tuple of the department. Then it goes for the second tuple, attached with every tuple with the department. Third tuple, fourth tuple. Now, once the processing of this entire block is completed, whether this block is required in future, yes or no, for the operation? I want the answer from you, yes or no? Whether this block is required in future again? Pass. Yes or no? To be replaced. And the least recently used block is required. So that policy is known as most recently used. Means the most recently used block is transferred from the main memory to the disk. So these are the different buffer replacement policies. So if the question is asked